Well, as we continue our coverage on the bitter boardroom battle, CNBC TV 18 has accessed the explanatory statement that Tata Sons have issued, seeking the removal of both Cyrus Mistry and Nasli Vadia from the board of Tata Group companies. The explanatory statement that we have accessed is for Tata Steel in specific. Arun Giri, who broke that story, joins us now. Arun, this is a confirmation of a CNBC TV 18 news break. The explanatory statement very clearly says that Cyrus Mistry and Nasli Vadia have been acting in concert post the 24th of October. Take us through the details.
Well, absolutely. Tata Sons has issued an explanatory statement for why they want to remove Mr. Cyrus Mistry and Mr. Nasli Vadia as directors of Tata Steel. The letter is addressed to the board of directors of the Tata Steel, and it in fact starts by saying that we are not required under Companies Act to issue any explanatory statement, but we do so for the benefit of the shareholders. We are doing so. And they go on to say, as far as Mr. Cyrus Mistry's removal is concerned, what are the key reasons they have given? First of all, they explain the structure of the Tata Group, the ethos, the fact that they are such a big group, that they employ 660,000 people, they are in 100 countries, and why are they there? What is their philosophy? And then they go on to say that the board of directors of Tata Sons on October 24th that revoked all executive powers of Mr. Mistry, replaced him as the executive chairman. And they said that they have lost full confidence. They have lost confidence in Mr. Mistry to lead Tata Sons for a combination of several factors. They also say that the board felt that the removal of Mr. Mistry as chairman was absolutely necessary for the future success of the Tata Group. They hammer home one very important point. They say that Tata Steel is an integral part of Tata Group and it enjoys the right to use the Tata brand by virtue of the Tata brand equity and business promotion agreement with Tata Steel and Tata Sons. And they say, I quote, substantial goodwill and benefits accrued to Tata Steel by such usage and association with the Tata Group. They allege that Mr. Mistry has not abided by the governance guidelines, that he's made unsubstantiated allegations and has cast aspersions, yeah, not only on Tata Sons and its board, but also on Tata Steel as a whole. So those are the reasons they have given for removal of Mr. Mistry. Now coming to Mr. Nasli Vadia, it's even more scathing. They basically say that Mr. Nasli Vadia, independent director on several boards in Tata Group, they say Mr. Vadia has been acting in concert with Mr. Cyrus Mistry and has been acting against the interests of the Tata Group. And they say, I quote, despite being purportedly an independent director on the boards of certain Tata companies, in our opinion, Mr. Nasli Vadia has been conducting himself as an interested party in a manner that is designed to cause harm to the Tata Group. He has not been conducting himself independently and instead has been inter alia galvanizing independent directors and acting prejudicially. And this may put the company and its future in grave jeopardy and impact the overall morale of the workers, employees and management who have joined the Tata company.
Well, you know, Arun, as you pointed out, that this is the explanatory statement which the Tatas point out that they didn't need to give, but they have given for the benefit of shareholders, etc., to explain the action. Now, you know, this is probably going to be exactly the same explanatory statement that will be issued for the boards of Tata Chemical and Tata Motors as well, when Nasli Vadia is on the board. But I want to go back to the point you know, that we're now sort of seeing this battle of independent directors versus the Tata Group. So far, it's only Nasli Vadia. Do you get a sense, Arun, that perhaps other independent directors could be dragged into this?
As of now, no. I think it was very important for Tata Group or for the Ratan Tata side to ensure that the dam do not burst when it comes to independent directors taking side of Mr. Mistry. And yesterday's Tata Steel board meeting, where three independent directors, a majority of the independent directors, refused to back the Nasli Vadia line on supporting Cyrus Mistry, I think that was very important. That has put pause and has got many independent directors in Tata Group to do a rethink on what is in the larger interest of the company, what is in the larger interest of the group. And I think the Tata Group yesterday, I talked to a senior source in the Tata Group, and he felt that the dams will now not burst, which was the worry 48 hours back. The way Mr. O.P. Bhatt very strongly asserted the contrarian viewpoint of certain independent directors. A majority of the independent directors in Tata Steel, I think, really put Mr. Wadia on the back foot. And if you look at some of the things that have come in the newspapers today, apart from most of which is what we reported yesterday, but if you look at some of the reports that suggest that Mr. Nusli Wadia actually threatened the MD and someone else, a senior employee of Tata Steel, of firing him, that Tata sources say is absolutely unacceptable. And apart from this, they have written evidence that Mr. Nusli Wadia was acting in concert with Mr. Sarasim.
Okay, so this is a bitter boardroom battle that's getting worse every day. But these are the important developments. CNBC TV 18 now has accessed the explanatory statement. So the Tatas corroborating the CNBC TV 18 news break that they believe Nusli Wadia was acting in concert with Cyrus Mistry from the 24th of October, and that Nusli Wadia acted in a manner designed to harm the interests of the Tata Group along with Cyrus Mistry. We haven't yet seen a response from Nusli Wadia, but I would imagine that maybe we will see one soon. But Arun, for now, thanks very much for joining us. That's the big CNBC TV 18 news break being confirmed.